If you're new to Linux, then you probably heard about Ubuntu. It is the most popular Linux distribution in the world. Not just limited to servers and other stuff, but it is the most popular choice for Linux desktops. It's super easy to use, it offers a pretty decent user experience, and it comes with all kinds of pre-installed tools to get you started. Now enter Ubuntu 22.04 long-term support, or LTS. By far the best looking Ubuntu distro yet. More features, better compatibility, and oh boy, is it ever fast. You don't believe me? Let's get installed right now on your Mac or PC. Let's go. We're going to do three different installs. The first one is going to be on macOS M1 chipset. The second one is going to be on VirtualBox, which will work for older Macs as well as Windows 10 and Windows 11. And the last install is going to be on a USB drive. I'm sure you have an old computer laying around somewhere. Well, now you can turn it into an Ubuntu killing machine. Just make sure you skip to the corresponding chapters down below, depending on your needs. Let's get to it. All right, so we're going to be installing Ubuntu 22.04 on, as you can see, my macOS Monterey 14-inch Apple M1 chipset, right? So for that, we're going to use this guy right here, which is Parallels. Now, let me show you Parallels. So this is the website, and Parallels is amazing. Parallels 17 is one of the best virtualization software that I've used ever, right? So the only thing is, like, you're going to have to pay for a license. So this is $99.99 Canadian, so that's probably about $70 US for the basic license. And if you want to go with the Pro Edition, then you have to pay $129 per year, which is not really that bad considering the quality of the software. It comes with this Parallels toolbox, which is pretty amazing. I mean, you can connect your printers, you can connect your external devices, and share information between desktops from your host to your actual client. So it is amazing, highly recommend. Okay, so let's go on with this. The second link that I wanna show you is this one here, and this is straight from the Ubuntu website, cdimage.ubuntu.com/jammy/daily-life. This is all the testing software that is happening inside of Ubuntu. And if you see this, the current is the one that you want to use because this is what has passed any automatic testing. So this is the one to test. This is the beta testers, right? So what you do is just click on current and then you get to this side here. And this is hidden from the public, but it's not really hidden. So I know a lot of YouTube videos out there, they're telling you to install the server first and then install the desktop on top of that, or install an old version of Ubuntu like 20.04 or 21.0 and then upgrade, but that doesn't work. It's just very cumbersome. This is the best way of doing it. So in here, I'm going to click on 64-bit ARM and I'm going to download this. Now this is going to take a little while. Just so you know, this also works for UTM. So if you go to the mac.getutm.app website, you can download this virtualizer and it's completely 100% free. However, it is prone to bugs. So it is a little buggy sometimes when you use it. So I just want to stick to the things that work in Parallels. Definitely works for me at least. Okay, perfect. My Jammy is downloaded. Now what I do is I go into Parallels Control Center, and as you can see, I have a Kali Linux system here, I have a couple of Ubuntus, and I have a Windows 11 running on my Parallels. So I'm going to click on this plus sign, and then I'm going to click on continue, install Windows or another OS, click, and then from here, I'm going to choose manually, select file, and just pick Jammy, continue. Give it a name, so GetCyber in my case, username GetCyber, password. You have to set a strong password or else it's not gonna let you continue. GetCyber Ubuntu, don't worry about any of this stuff, just create. If you see this, don't worry about it. It talks about the optical disk or any of that stuff, don't worry. Just click OK. and try or install Ubuntu. The reason it's saying try is because this is the live version of Ubuntu, the one that you install on a USB drive and then plug it in, see Ubuntu, test it out, and then unplug it or take it out of your computer, and then it continues to run. So, well, this is a really funky looking screen. There you go. Perfect. It's already installed. And as you can see, this is the live version of Ubuntu. So it is temporary. So as soon as you turn off your computer or Perls, then you're going to have to install it again. In this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to permanently install Ubuntu. So just click on install Ubuntu 22.04. Makes a really nice sound. Continue, English US. And I'm going to install the third-party software as well for graphics. Continue, erase disk, install now, continue. And set the time, Toronto, Canada, my name again, GetCyber1, computer's name, GetCyber1. Perfect. And continue. This is so exciting, guys. I love Ubuntu 22.04. It's amazing. As soon as you start trying it, you're gonna fall in love with it. I guarantee you. So the third video on this tutorial is giving you, I'm going to give you tips on how to optimize Ubuntu, what you need to do after you install Ubuntu on your computer to make it much better. All right, fast forward a little bit. All done. So now I'm going to restart. And if you see this, don't worry about it. This is just asking you for the CD-ROM. So just click on enter. And this is the last time you're going to see that screen. All right, GetCyber. Let's log in. Perfect. Now I'm going to click on full view like that. Skip, skip, skip. And there you go. Now you have Ubuntu installed on your macOS M1 Silicon Chipset. Now let's get installing it on VirtualBox right now.
All right, so the second install, I'm going to do it on a VirtualBox. And as you can see, I'm here in my studio and the computer that we need is right on this side. So how about we get to it?
Okay, so this is my Windows 11 machine. And the first thing I'm going to do is get Ubuntu. So I'm going to go into my browser, type in Ubuntu desktop, like that, and click on download in here. Ubuntu 22.04 LTS download.
All right, so while this is downloading, I just want to let you know that this process is going to work for older versions of macOS, so Catalina and before, as well as Windows 10 and Windows 11. So using VirtualBox, if you haven't downloaded, then go to the Oracle website to download VirtualBox. I'm going to put a link down on the bottom in the description of the video.
Okay, perfect. So it's already downloaded. The next step is to go into your VirtualBox and click on new, and we're going to give it a name. So Ubuntu GetCyber, Linux Ubuntu 64-bit, click on next, and we're going to give it some good memory size. So probably about, in my case, I have a lot of memory, so I'm going to give it 12 gigabytes of memory, create a virtual hard disk now. VDI, so VirtualBox disk image, click on next, and dynamically allocated. Click next, and for disk space, I'm going to give it probably, I don't know, maybe about 45 gigabytes. I think that's plenty. Click on create. Wonderful. Now click on start. From here, what you have to do is click on the folder icon. Click on add and choose the Ubuntu 22.04 desktop ISO that you downloaded. Click on open and click on choose. And now click on start. From here, just click on try or install Ubuntu. Perfect. Now you click on install Ubuntu, English US, continue. And here, this is very important. You need to install the third-party software for graphic and Wi-Fi. VirtualBox does not support acceleration out of the box. So make sure you click on that and then click on continue. Click on install now and click on continue. Select your time zone, give it a name, so GetCyber. Password. And click on continue. And now we just wait. Okay, let's restart the computer now. All right, if your Ubuntu machine gets stuck like this, there is a troubleshooting tip that I can give you. So what you need to do is kill the virtual machine, then get out of here. And what I want you to do is go into your control panel like that and search for features. Turn Windows features on and off, click on that. And then what you need to do here is unclick Hyper-V and go all the way down and unclick Windows Subsystem for Linux, because that might be interfering with your virtual box. Click OK. And restart your computer. Okay, perfect. So now what you do is go back to your virtual box like that and click on start. Perfect. Our Ubuntu machine is already set. Now let's log in, enter my password. Great. Skip. Skip, next, next, and now click on apps and look for settings. Inside the settings, look for display. Perfect. Now look for your monitor's resolution. Mine is 1920 by 1080. There you go. Now click and apply. So now you have a full Ubuntu 22.04 installed on your virtual machine. Now let's move on to the next install. All right, so for the last part of the video, I have this guy right here. And this is my old MacBook Pro. I think it's 2013 or 14. And so I'm going to install Ubuntu on this guy. You can see this is my old pentesting MacBook. And you're also going to need one of these little guys. Make sure you have a USB that has over 5 gigabytes, 6 gigabytes and up, right? So these two things. And what we're going to do is install a bare metal Ubuntu desktop on an old computer. I'm pretty sure you have a computer laying around somewhere. Just go get it. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this USB drive on the USB port. And after that, then if you get this little window, don't worry about this, just ignore, because we're going to download Belana Etcher. Go into your browser, type in Belana Etcher. So just download for macOS or Windows. This works for Windows as well, like that. And click on open file, put Belana Etcher on your applications like that. Open your applications. And now let's just power up Belana Etcher. Oh, there you go. All right, so we are ready to start burning a USB drive. All right, the next step is to go to the Ubuntu website, or you can search for Ubuntu 22.04 desktop. Perfect. So click on the first link and download the 64-bit PC AMD 64 like this. All right, so my file has already downloaded. So I'm going to power up my Belana, click on flash from file, select the Ubuntu ISO that we just downloaded, select the target, USB drive with 31 gigabytes, and click on flash. Oh, of course, I'm going to have to type in my password in here. And now we wait for a little bit. Perfect. So now it's done. So all you have to do now is just pull the USB out and it's ready to go. The only thing is, like, if you are using a machine, you need to press 12 when you start it, or you need to press some sort of combination. Sometimes it's the escape key, sometimes it's the alt. Just make sure that you know how to boot from a USB on your computer. And that's the end. It was super easy to install Ubuntu on your computer. Now, if you have any questions, any comments, make sure you use the box down below. And don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.